हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज लेसन नंबर 3, डिमांड. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द मीनिंग. व्हाट इज डिमांड? डिमांड इज द क्वांटिटी ऑफ अ कमोडिटी विच अ बायर डिजायर्स इज एबल एंड विलिंग टू बाय एट अ गिवन प्राइस एट अ गिवन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. इट मीन्स वेन एवर द बायर डिजायर्स, उसकी जब इच्छा होती है, वेन एवर ही इज एबिलिटी टू परचेज at a given price, at a given point of time, it is called demand. Means उसकी खरीदने की इच्छा भी होगी, उसके पास उतना पैसा भी होगा, प्लस वो जिस रेट पे चाहता है उस रेट पे भी मिलेगा, प्लस सही टाइम पे मिलेगा. दैट इज़ नोन एज डिमांड. लेट्स सी व्हाट इज़ लॉ ऑफ डिमांड एंड डिमांड शेड्यूल. लॉ ऑफ डिमांड, द प्रिंसिपल एक्सप्लेनिंग द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन प्राइस एंड डिमांड फॉर अ गुड कीपिंग द इफेक्ट ऑफ ऑल अदर डिटर्मिनेंट्स एज कॉन्स्टेंट इज कॉल्ड द लॉ ऑफ डिमांड. मीन्स लॉ ऑफ डिमांड एक्सप्लेन अस द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन वॉट प्राइज एंड डिमांड बाई कीपिंग ऑल द अदर फैक्टर्स डिटर्मिनेंट्स एज कॉन्स्टेंट बाई कीपिंग ऑल द फैक्टर्स कॉन्स्टेंट इट इज कॉल्ड लॉ ऑफ डिमांड. इट ऑल्सो शोज अस द दैट प्राइज इज द कॉज वेरिएबल एंड डिमांड इज द इफेक्ट वेरिएबल. Law of demand also shows us that price is the cost variable and demand is the effect variable. That means price is the cost and demand is the effect. This law was presented by Professor Alfred Marshall. Who has presented this law? This law is being presented by Alfred Marshall and it expresses the inverse relationship between price and demand. It shows the inverse relationship. Inverse means whenever the price will be high, demand will be less. Whenever the price will be less, demand will be high. Price and demand, stating that when other factors influencing demand remain unchanged, if price of a good falls, it demands expands. If price of a good rises, it demands contracts. Means whenever the price will be more, demand will be less. Whenever the price will be less, demand will be more. Let us see how the inverse relationship between price and demand take place by having some few assumptions first. First, there are few assumptions regarding to the law of demand. First one is taste and preference of the consumer remain unchanged. Means whenever there will be demand or anything, ठीक है, उस टाइम पे क्या होगा, taste and preference change नहीं होगा. Income of a consumer remains unchanged. Price of substitute and complementary goods remain unchanged. Consumers do not make anticipation regarding future prices. Size of population also remains the same. Means these are the assumptions. This will not take any kind of changes. Whenever the law of demand is showing the relationship between price and demand. Now let's have the demand schedule. The schedule showing willingness of a consumer to buy different quantities of a good at various prices is called the demand schedule. The following schedule is an abstract example of the demand schedule. Abstract means an imaginary. Abstract means it is already given an imaginary. That means demand schedule means the graph, with the help of graph it will be explaining all the what will be the price, then what will be the demand. What will be the, whenever the price will be increasing, what will be the demand. Whenever the price will be decreasing, what will be the demand. With the help of graph, it will be explaining the relationship between price and demand. This is called demand schedule. Here we can see the price and demand of a milk is given. When the price is 50, demand of milk is 1 liter. When the price is 40, demand of milk is 2 liter. When price is 30, demand of liter is milk is 3 liter. When price is 20, demand of milk is 4 liter. When price is 10, demand of milk is 5 liter. Here we can see the graph. Here we can see the graph. The horizontal line, it is known as x-axis. The vertical line, it is known as y-axis. The horizontal line is known as x-axis, the vertical line is known as y-axis. The graph always starts with zero. The graph always starts with zero. Now let's see. When the price is 50, The demand of a liter is 1. Plot a dot. On x-axis, I forgot to say, whenever the x-axis is there, it is horizontal line. On that, we have to write the demand of a milk. And always on the y-axis, it determines the price of milk. Now, let's draw the demand curve. How to draw the demand curve now? Whenever the price is 50, the liter was 1 liter. So, 1 liter and 50. Wherever it meets, just put a dot. When price is 40, demand is 2 liter. Price 40, demand 2. Wherever it meets, put a dot. 33. That means 30 is the price, demand is 3. Put. In the same way, dot the plots and draw a line. This line is known as demand curve. This line is known as demand curve. It always moves from left to right downwards. It always moves from left to right and also downwards. Okay. Now here see. The above diagram shows price of milk on y-axis and demand of milk on x-axis. By plotting the demand given in the schedule at various prices, we obtain the various points A, B, C, D, E. That means wherever we have dotted, they have given the name as A, B, C, D and E. Which shows the various price demand combinations. By joining these points, we get the demand curve, that is DD. By joining these points, we get the line, that is DD. DD means demand curve. Which slopes downward from left to right, indicating the inverse relationship between price and demand. At point A, the price is 50 and the demand is 1 liter. At point B, the price is 40 and the demand is 2 liter. At point C, price is 30, demand is 3 liter. At point D, price is 20, demand is 4 liter. At point E, price is 10 and the demand is 5 liter. That means wherever the price is high, the demand is less. Wherever the price is less, demand is high. This shows the inverse relationship between the price and demand. Now, analysis. Reason for inverse relationship between price and demand. Now, why this is happening? There are two types of effects, income effect and substitution effect. Income effect, when the monetary income of the consumer remains constant, but price of the good falls, then his or he, her real income rises. Real income is the purchasing power of money income. When real income rises, a consumer can buy more of a good and therefore its demand may rise. For example, here income effect is given with the example. Let's see the example. If the amount of money at the disposable of a consumer is rupees 50 and the price of a milk is rupees 50 per liter, then the consumer can buy demand only 1 liter of milk. If the consumer income is 50 and the price of a milk is also 50, then how much he can purchase? Only 1 liter of milk. But if the price of milk falls to rupees 10, the consumer can now demand 5 liters of milk with money income of rupees 50. His income will not change. But if the price of a goods falls down, that means he is having enough money to purchase it. So he will buy more. When he was having rupees 50 income and price of milk was 50 rupees per liter, that means he can buy only 1 liter of milk. अगर वो चाहेगा 5 लीटर खरीदना 2 लीटर खरीदना तो भी नहीं खरीद पाएगा क्योंकि उसका इनकम ही 50 रुपीज़ है एंड दूध का परचेज मीन्स दूध का प्राइस भी कितना है 50 रुपीज़ ही है बट अगर उसका इनकम 50 है बट दूध का रेट कितना हो गया है 10 रुपीज़ दैट मीन्स ही कैन ईजिली परचेज 5 लीटर्स अप टू 5 लीटर मीन्स वो चाहे तो 2 लीटर भी खरीद सकता है 3 लीटर भी 4 लीटर भी या तो 5 लीटर भी खरीद सकता है मोस्टली नॉर्मल गुड्स हैव अ पॉजिटिव इनकम इफेक्ट Inferior goods have a negative income effect. Means most of the goods are having positive income effect, but the inferior goods are having negative income effect. That is, when the price of an inferior goods falls, the real income of the consumer increases, but the demand of these goods falls. For example, coarse food grains. Now, what is inferior goods? Inferior goods means bad quality of goods. अगर उसका rate कम भी हो जाएगा तो भी लोग उसको खरीदेंगे नहीं क्यों? क्योंकि उसका quality अच्छा नहीं होता है. नेक्स्ट इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन इफेक्ट. व्हेन प्राइस ऑफ द कंसर्न गुड फॉल्स इट बिकम्स रिलेटिवली चीपर देन इट सब्स्टिट्यूट्स. हियर अ कंज्यूमर विल रिड्यूस द कंजम्पशन ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड्स एंड एक्सपांड द डिमांड फॉर द कंसर्न गुड्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल बिटवीन टू वराइटीज ऑफ पैंट्स नेमली अ पेयर ऑफ रेगुलर कॉटन टेरी कॉटन पैंट्स एंड डेनिम पैंट्स. If the price of regular pants falls and that of denim pants remains the same, then the consumer finds the regular pants cheaper compared to the denim pants and will expand the demand for the regular pants. Coconut water and cold drinks. Example, here the next example is given of coconut water and cold drinks. That means, suppose if the coconut water is of rupees 30 and cold drink is of 40. ठीक है, तभी कौन सा खरीदेंगे साहब? कोकोनट वाटर, बिकॉज दे नो कि कोकोनट वाटर इज चीपर देन कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स. तो कहीं पे भी जाएंगे अगर उनको प्यास लगेगा तो वो क्या खरीदेंगे? कोकोनट वाटर. ओके, दिस टू इफेक्ट्स इज द एनालिसिस विच शोज द इनवर्स रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन प्राइस एंड डिमांड. थैंक यू.